Here it finally is, the most powerful Sony mirrorless camera on the planet right now, the Sony a7S III. I'm gonna tell you everything you need to know about this camera. The camera body features the same ergonomics as this a7 R4, but it's 1 millimeter thicker. It weighs in at 614 grams, which is slightly less than the Canon R5, which is at 650 grams. It is powered by brand spanking new 12 megapixel back illuminated sensor. This low light monster can go up to 409,000 ISO like the A7S II, but the performance is a lot better. And in an upcoming video, I push it to the absolute limit, shooting 50,000 ISO plus and getting decent quality out of it. So stay tuned for that video. It has the highest resolution viewfinder Sony has ever made, 9.4 million dot EVF. Insane, it's so crystal clear. Got a fully articulating screen like the ZV-1 with full touch control, so you can navigate through the menus and even pinch to zoom when reviewing photos. This was long overdue. You know what else is long overdue? A new menu system, and they finally addressed it. It is so much easier to navigate through and find what you're looking for. It has a new heat dispersion design that allows over an hour long recording of 4K 60, according to Sony. But in the real world, we were able to shoot over 3 hours of 4K 120, not continuous, but in spurts, in 95 degree Chicago heat, and it didn't overheat once or give any indication of overheating. Super impressive. We were able to get almost 100 megabytes of footage, and we still had 14% left on that battery. It features 5 stops of image stabilization with electronic stabilization as an option, but that will give you a 10% crop on the image. This camera features 4 card slots. 2 UHS-II card slots that we're all very familiar with, and a new kind of card called CF Express Type A. It's similar to the card that's in the Canon R5, but they are smaller. They read up to 800 megabytes and write up to 700 megabytes. For the first time ever in a Sony mirrorless camera, you get a full-size HDMI port. You get a USB-C Type-C, mic jack, headphone jack, and USB micro. All right, the moment you've been waiting for, let's talk about those juicy video specs. You get 4K full pixel readout without binning in all recording modes with no recording limit on this camera. You get 15 stops of dynamic range in video. You get 16-bit raw output to an external recorder using the full HDMI port while still retaining IAF and subject tracking. Yes, you heard me correctly. That's insane. The rolling shutter jello effect has also been dramatically improved on the A7S III. This is the A7 III, 24 frames per second at 4K. This is the A7S III, 24 frames at 4K. Look at how much better and how much less jello there is. You can shoot XAVCS i4K, which is intra-frame, which is the highest quality 4K it can output. You can do that in 24, 30, and 60 frames per second. And in 60 frames per second, you're getting up to 600 megabytes. 422 10-bit video files. Good luck to you and your computer. In regular 4K, you get 24, 30, 60, and 120 frames per second. Like I said before, we were able to shoot 4K 120 at 280 megabytes a second, 422 10-bit with no overheating on this super hot day. In terms of video crop, you're only getting it in one frame rate. That's when you're shooting 4K 120. You're getting a 1.1 times crop. With all the other frame rates, you're not getting any crop. You can shoot 1080p at 240 frames per second, S-Log 2 and 3, with 10-bit 422 being available in almost all of the recording modes. In autofocusing, 759 autofocusing points that work with all the video formats. You guys don't understand the subject and the real-time IAF and the subject tracking. It is absolutely mind-blowing. You have to try it out for yourself. It's gonna lock on, it's not gonna let go. When it comes to the Sony a7S III and photography, you got the 12 megapixel sensor, get 10 frames per second shooting, you got over 700 focusing points, and you got that fast FTP transfer, which is great for photojournalists that don't need that all that resolution. They just need fast transfer speeds. I'm doing a specific video on the photography of the Sony a7S III and what the files look like, shooting uncompressed RAW. Subscribe for that video. I just filmed it and I'm gonna be editing it, posting it this week. So stay tuned for that. Now, I know what a lot of you guys are gonna be asking. Why didn't Sony put an 24 megapixel sensor in the Sony a7S III? And there is an easy answer to that. Sony has divided their cameras in different categories, right? The S line is for video, a7 III is like that semi-pro hybrid camera that can do it all. Then you got the R line, which is for resolution. Canon decided to create the holy grail hybrid camera with everything in it, okay? If you're looking for one camera, just one, that can do everything, the Canon R5 is very, very appealing. Me personally, I like the division in cameras. I like to have a camera like this, a7S III, or I'm recording right now, 4K 60, 12 to 24 with a flippy screen. I love having a dedicated camera for video. I got the flip, oh my God, I got the flippy screen. This camera is gonna be my dedicated video camera. I have the a7 III, a7 R3 dedicated for my photography. Now let's talk about all the overheating tests that are gonna be coming out because I don't have the R5, so I can't compare. There are gonna be a lot of people comparing the S3 and the R5 with the overheating. Now, regardless of what the outcome is, let me tell you right now, I actually tested it in the real world, how I would use it. 4K 120, my iMac Pro, for the first time ever, it choked. And for the first time ever, the fan kicked on when I tried to render out this video with 4K 20 files. They're massive. You're gonna be shooting more 1080p than you ever have in your life because unless you have the computing power, you're not gonna be doing these high frame rates. It is absolutely insane. I shot up to almost 100 megabytes of footage outdoors, 3 hours, super hot day. And the camera gave no indication of overheating, not even an indication. Ryan was doing my video. I told him, let me know if anything pops up. Nothing popped up. All he did was rave about the tracking, how insanely good the tracking was with the IEF. She turns her back, it goes to subject tracking. Imagine doing that 4K 120. Then you can also do a 4K 60-bit RAW using an external monitor. What? Are you serious right now? But let me get back to the overheating because I totally diverted there. I use the camera in the real world. No overheating issues. It's all about how you use the camera. Putting both cameras in the sun and just letting them heat up and seeing which one overheats first, which is whether it's the Canon or Sony, is not the right way to test these cameras because you got to be very, 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 very conservative with how you shoot. In my opinion, this is going to be the best camera for vlogging and filming yourself and content creation. And this is the reason why. You got all the third-party options in lenses for Sony. It's Tamron 17-28 2.8 under $1,000. You got the 21.8 Sony. You've got all these options under $1,000 or around $1,000 with amazing image quality versus Canon, you're gonna end up spending over $2,000 to get into that. But of course, Canon does have an advantage here because their lenses have IBIS. So you're using IBIS in the body, IBIS in the lens. You're probably gonna have better image stabilization. I need to test out the image stabilization on the Sony properly with another lens that has IS, compare it with the Canon R5. I think that'll be a great head-to-head because we all know Sony never really known for its great image stabilization in the body. So I need to test that out and I will be doing it. This week, I will be dropping like 3 S3 videos, one in extremely low light, like 50,000 ISO. The camera can put out clean files. It's pretty insane. I'm gonna save that for the video, okay? And if you wanna pre-order it, I think that I'll try to put a link down below. If you want this camera, you gotta pre-order it fast. I have a feeling that it's gonna be hard to come across in the beginning, okay? Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one.